Dear students, welcome back to my class. Today we are starting with the 7th chapter, that is population interaction. And today we are starting with the topic intraspecific and interspecific interactions. Let's move. Before moving to the topic, we should know what is meant by a population interaction. Here you can see that in this picture there are a lot of interactions are generally taking place by or generally done by different organisms. Here the best example is the interaction between a bee and a flower. Here in this interaction there are two different species are involved, one plant and another an animal, right? And here you can see that different mammals as well as the birds are interacting with each other for getting the flesh of this animal. So this is another interaction. Here you can see that two birds, a mother bird is feeding its young one. So this is another kind of interaction. Here a fish is interacting with a coral. Okay, so what is mean by a population interaction in the sense that it is an interaction or interrelationship between all the members of a species. We know that in a population there will be the occurrence of all the members which belong to one species. What about community? In community, there involves the interaction of different species. Okay, so the kind of the interaction and interrelationship generally constitute what? Population interaction. Okay, then what about their persistence? They may be temporary, casual, prolonged, or permanent. So we can define population interaction in another way, that is, it is an interaction which occurs between the similar individuals which is coming under the same species, as well as the interaction of the similar individuals with a taxonomically unrelated species. Okay, one, this as per this definition we can say that this interaction of which is taking place between the similar individuals of the same species is a interaction which is taking place in a single population, while the interaction of the same individuals with the taxonomically unrelated species generally involves their interaction with another member, that is this is the interaction which is generally taking place in a community. Okay, so the former is a single population interaction, while the later is a community interaction. Generally, there are two different types of interactions are seen. They are categorized as intraspecific interaction and interspecific interaction. In the case of intraspecific interaction, this involves the interaction between all the members which belongs to one species. That means the interaction which is limited or which is taking place within a single species is called an intraspecific interaction. Here you can see that in this picture two mammals are interacting with each other. They are coming under one species. This is an intraspecific interaction. While the case of interspecific interaction, this interaction generally involves the interaction between two different species. Okay, here you can see that a lion and a zebra is interacting with each other. So the involvement of two different species generally constitute interspecific interaction. If this interspecific interaction is generally taking place in a community level, while interspecific interaction is generally taking place in a single population. Okay, then comes to the intraspecific interaction. For the effective establishment of intraspecific interaction, generally two different kinds of interactions are generally taking place. They are competition and cooperation. Let's move to the detail. What is meant by competition? Competition generally occurs whenever there occurs overcrowdedness, overpopulation, or there exists a severe scarcity of food resources. On the above situation only, what happens? Competition occurs. And how this happens? In competition, only one member of a species which will compete with the other members of that particular species for what? For basic needs such as food, space, moisture, mates, as well as protection. Here you can see that in this picture, all these four animals are coming under one species. They are competing with each other for getting the flesh of this animal. So this is called a competition. And I told you that this is mainly depends upon population. Whenever there occurs overpopulation, there happen competition. So this is a density dependent one. Okay. Then if you are considering a forest, in a forest there are different kinds of plants like herbs, shrubs, trees, etc. All these plants will compete for what? Their basic needs such as sunlight, water, space, etc. So we can say that the competition of all these plants for their basic needs is an intraspecific competition. If you are considering an animal, they are competing for what? Food, shelter, predators, enemies, mate, etc. Okay, so that's all about the general idea about what competition. Then what about the advantage of this intraspecific competition? The intraspecific competition generally maintains a balance between available resources and the individual which is sharing this particular resource. It generally promotes a favorable adaptation as well as specialization, which means by means of competition, only those animal which is better able to live in the environment will be selected by the nature and other will be eliminated. So those selected individuals will be having certain peculiar special characters or adaptation. So we can say that the evolutionary point of view, this intraspecific competition promotes favorable adaptations. Clear? Then apart from this competition, there occurs another interaction in intraspecific interaction that is called a cooperation. Cooperation generally meant for providing protection, defense, survival, and propagation of all members which belongs to one species. And how this cooperation generally takes place? These are the different methods in which the animals are generally undergoing cooperation, or they undergo cooperative behavior by means of all these things. In the case of mating, both male and females undergoes a different courtship behavior or a mating behavior for making a successful reproduction. After the progeny is produced, the parents, either the male or female parents, will take care of the young ones, that is parental care. Then group formation for reducing the predation, parasitism and other harmful effects. The group formation is very much important. Altruism. Altruism is a phenomenon in which if you are considering a group, within a group, only one member will sacrifice its life for the benefit of the rest of the others. That is called the altruism. For example, in the case of honeybee colony, you can say that the worker bees are generally, they are sacrificing their life for the benefit of the queen and other male members of the that colony. Okay, that is called altruism. Then dominant hierarchies and leaderships. All these characters are generally associated with the group formation. This dominant hierarchy as well as the leadership are very much important for reducing what the defense, for reducing what the conflict between different members and thereby providing protection. Then territoriality. We know that territoriality is a condition in which all the members of a particular species or as particular species will always maintain a geographical boundary for providing protection to their life. Then communication. Effective communication is also very much important for their survival. So these are the different kinds of cooperative behavior which is shown, or cooperative interaction which is shown by the members within the species. Then comes the interspecific interaction. I told you that interspecific interaction involves the interaction between different species. Okay, so their interactions are generally classified into three different categories. They are neutral interaction, positive or beneficial interaction, negative or harmful interaction. Okay, so let's move to the detail. What is meant by neutral interaction? As the name indicates, neutral interaction involves interaction which neither species are beneficial nor harmful. For example, if you are considering this example, this is a squirrel and this is a robin bird. These two species are generally interacting with each other for the same resources. Even though they are interacting with, or even though they are utilizing the same resources like this tree, they do not have any kind of interaction. Right? This is called a neutral interaction. They are not disturbing each other. Not beneficial, not harmful. Clear? Then comes the positive interaction. In the case of positive interaction, the interacting species. For interaction to be taking place, there will be the availability of two members, minimum two members. So, the both these members will be equally benefited. But there is no harmful to or harmfulness to the interacting ones. That is called a positive or beneficial interaction. One of the most important phenomena which is found in this positive interaction is called a mutualism. Mutualism involves a symbiotic association which is beneficial to both the interacting species. Here you can see that this is a common example. Here there occurs a mutualism between this a bird and a mammal. Here the bird what will do is that it will generally feeds upon the ticks and mites which is present in the body surface of this mammal. So this bird will get food from the body surface. What about the animal? The animal will be free from the ticks and mites, and it will provide, it will be escaped, or it will be free from diseases. So in this particular reaction, both these members are equally what benefited. This is called a positive or beneficial interaction. And in this interaction, there are generally two types of interactions are generally seen. They are called obligatory mutualism and facultative mutualism. In the case of obligatory mutualism, there requires a constant physical interaction or intimate physiological relationship between the interacting members. Here the partners are completely dependent upon each other, and they cannot survive when they are getting separated. You may be knowing that lichens. Lichen is an association of algae and fungus. And algae constitute the phycobiont, and it prepares food by means of photosynthesis. Right? And fungi means it is a fungal pod. It is also called a mycobiont. It will generally provide shelter, protection, and moisture and minerals to the algae. So here, one will prepare food for the other, that is algae, while the fungus will provide shelter for the former, that is algae. This is called the obligatory mutualism. Another example is association between Trichonifer and Termite. Trichonifer is a cellulose digesting enzyme which is found in the intestine of termite. Okay, so here the Trichonifer gets shelter in the body of this termite, and in the case of termite, the cellulose is mainly digested by this bacteria. So there occurs an association. Then another one is association between roaches and bacteria. Then association between ruminant mammals and bacteria, which is dwelling in the stomach of this ruminant mammals like a cow. Then facultative mutualism. This is a quite opposite condition in which the neither constant contact or functional association or physiological relationships are found in between the interacting members. Here both the partners are able to survive when they are getting separated. The best example is called the association between the hermit crab and the sea anemone. The crab is an arthropod and sea anemone is an what? This is an echinoderm. Hermit crab will provide food to the sea anemone, and the sea anemone will generally provide protection to this hermit crab. Okay, so this is called a facultative mutualism. Another example is the association between crocodile and a crocodile boat. Here you can see that whenever the crocodile is getting wide in its mouth, the crocodile boat will come and it will feed upon the food materials and other bacteria and other microorganisms which is dwelling in its mouth. So here this bird is getting food from this crocodile. Then the next one is the association between rhizozyme and rhizome and leguminous plants. You can see bacteria, nitrogen fixing bacteria. Their association can also be taken as an example of facultative mutualism. So I hope you understood what is meant by this intraspecific and interspecific interaction. Thank you.